resource locator. The unique name for every website is there. So within that, there could be some additional information that is shared when the visitor is going from the affiliate website to the merchant website. So that is called unique ID of each and every transaction, right? Links set a cookie on the customer's computer system, which allows the software to track the sales also, right? So in the cookies, we will be able to share that, okay, these many websites, these many pages the customer has visited. On the basis of that, we will be able to track whether the sales has happened or not, whether the revenue has to be shared or not. So one example of tracking, you can see a long URL on the top of the screen. So what is happening in this? There is lots of information. Affiliate ID is equal to 238. Merchant ID is equal to 214. And program ID is equal to 3897. And the URL www.firebox.com index.html. So that is a website on which the person has landed. So because of all these unique identification numbers, we will be able to track that, okay, this customer has come from this particular website to my sales website. And we can actually decide upon the revenue sharing and the payment systems. One more example you can see on the top, if the person has come from a affiliate future source, you can see in the URL, macfarlanepackaging.com/UTM source, that UTM source equal to affiliate future 8 and affiliate UTM medium is equal to affiliate marketing. This is how this company macfarlanepackaging.com will be able to understand that this person has come from one particular website. Accordingly, I can settle their payment systems. Okay. Okay. Tracking completion. Once the transaction has happened, completion of the action, cookie helps the software to collect the information. What kind of information? It will actually check whether this person is the same person who has made the transaction or not. Referring URL and affiliate will be identified. Total sales amount and the commission will be calculated. Date and time of sales will also be calculated, and unique order number of sales will also be traced. If the transaction is valid, then definitely the transaction will be calculated for revenue, right? So how the tracking will be done? Software collects the information even when the no action is complete. Even if the sales has not happened, the software will collect the information. Okay, these many clicks happened, these many people visited the website, these many people put the product in their cart, but finally they did not complete the transaction. So that both the parties, affiliate can also measure that, okay, I am generating so many clicks for this particular merchant, but they are not converting. They are actually hurting my revenue. So what should I do? I should look for the options. I can show some other merchants advertisement on my platform. Why do I waste my resources? Right? So merchants can also check which particular type of banner advertisement is working. Maybe there is some problem in the banner design or the content, or I am placing my advertisement on the wrong affiliate platform itself, right? So both sides, we can optimize our campaigns. One small advertisement report for my previous institution, you can see on the screen, on day wise, number of clicks, number of impressions, click through rate, costing of the campaign, average position of my banner, conversions, cost per conversion, and conversion rate. All these statistics are being shown by my affiliate marketing platform. On the basis of that, I can check whether my platform is good enough or not, which particular cost is getting me how many conversions, right? So also it will help me in identifying on which particular date or time the conversion rate is high. For example, on 20th of January, you can see conversions are 13, but there is one day, that is 26th of January, the number of conversion is very, very poor, that is 7. Even on 25th, it is only one single conversion. So we need to check what went wrong, right? So these campaign reports need to be properly checked. Okay, cookies we have already discussed. So for cookie, there needs to be a time frame. how much of time the cookie will store the data. Generally, the time could be 30 to 60 days. So what happens if the customer goes to the affiliate website, looks at an advertisement, clicks on it, goes to the merchant website, whether they do the transition or not, they do the repeat visit after maybe 2-3 days, 5 days, they do another transition. After 20 days, they go for the another transition. So what happens for the full cookie time, whatever number of transactions have happened, the affiliate will get the commission. So what happens? The affiliates prefer to have the longer cookie period, which can go up to maybe 1 year or maybe 999 days or maybe lifetime cookies also. So these are some concerns in affiliate marketing, right? So affiliate wants to keep on getting the commission over a longer period of time because they claim that, yes, it was us who has actually sent the customer to the merchant. It was us who has introduced a brand to the customer. So we should get the maximum revenue. But the situation comes when the same customer has visited multiple affiliate platforms within that period. So what happens in that case? The most recent affiliate will be made the payment. Or there could be some sharing of the commission. Maybe there are 4 or 5 affiliates whom I have visited on the same day and I have done a transition later on. So what happens in that case, all those affiliates might actually claim for their share of revenue. So it is dependent upon the policy that has been decided by affiliate network and agreed upon by the merchant. Okay, so affiliate will try to get longer cookie period. And we need to find out how to settle the multiple referrals, whom to give the money, right? Cookies getting a bad reputation also because they are active for longer period of time. So many a times we struggle with settling the claims from multiple affiliates. So because there could be some conflict, so what happens? The transition has happened. A person has bought a laptop, 30,000 rupees, and the revenue for affiliate should have been maybe 500 rupees. But because of the dispute, the affiliate is not getting it. So they might not be the beneficiary of the transition despite sending the visitor to a merchant website. So we have to find the solutions for that. Clashing cookies, tracking for optimizing efforts or technical change on the websites also. Many a times the website design or the website content has been revised. So in that case, affiliate will struggle to find out their transactions, right? Because whatever URL they were actually directing previously, now that has been changed. The name of the web page has been changed because of the redesign of the website by the merchant. So in that case, all the affiliates will be losing their revenue, right? If the customer completes the action, but not online, the affiliate will not get any commission. I was talking about the same. Just imagine if somebody has seen an advertisement on gadi.com, but they are going to the showroom and making a purchase, maybe a 10 lakh rupees car they're buying, but gadi.com will not get any share of revenue. Why? Because the transition has happened in offline mode. So in that case, there can be no settlement of payment. Okay. Promoting merchants. Affiliates are digital marketers who are paid on performance based. They are sending you the targeted customer, right? So we need to find out as an affiliate that we are actually sending the best kind of candidate to the merchant website. Okay, so I hope some of you are using a website called coupondunia.com. How that coupondunia.com actually works, they are one of the good example of affiliate marketing. They have advertisements and the discount coupons, special discount coupons, which are not available elsewhere that will be shared with coupondunia because they are doing affiliate marketing for so many brands. They are giving you special discounts or cashbacks on your flight bookings, hotel reservations, or maybe some mobile purchase from e-commerce company or any kind of activity that you are doing, whether it is grocery or something, right? So this company, Coupondunia, they claim that, okay, if you go for a flight booking with us, we will give you some special cashback that you will not find elsewhere. Even if you go to directly to Indigo, you will find the same ticket price at maybe 5,000 rupees. You go to Make My Trip, you may get a 100 rupees discount over there, maybe 4,900. But if you go to Coupon Duniya, and from Coupon Duniya, you're going to Make My Trip, buying the ticket. So you are getting that ticket for 4,900 plus a 100 rupees cashback is being provided to you by Coupon Duniya. Why this is happening? Make My Trip may not be able to reach out to me. Maybe I was planning to buy the ticket directly from some other website, maybe yatra.com or Clear Trip, or maybe from Indigo Airlines, right? But because of Coupon Duniya, that special offer that was being shown to me, I was attracted to it. I went to Make My Trip, and resulted into a sales for them. Sales means some revenue for them. And they are happy to share this additional revenue, because this is additional. I was not intending to go to Make My Trip. I was a loyal customer maybe for Yatra, but because of Coupon Duniya, I have been taken to a new website, right? So this is how these companies are actually helping you to promote your business to those unknown territories. All those populations that I was not able to reach out, I am able to now with the help of affiliate marketing, right? Affiliate types, different types of affiliates are there. Personal websites are there. I may have my own blog on which I am promoting your business. Content or niche sites. Content sites, for example, some specific websites which have been created for a particular topic, right? For example, today you are having websites for COVID-19, or maybe some IPL is going on. So there are special websites which have been created for sharing the people's feedback or maybe some expert opinions. So content websites, email list. Some companies are having their own database of emails and they are sharing all kinds of coupons within one email. That is being done by Coupon Duniya also. Loyalty websites, which are giving you some cashbacks or some charitable donations. Coupon and promotion websites, just like our Coupon Duniya. Comparison shopping, companies like Policy Bazaar, they are giving you comparison shopping, right? Search affiliates, some companies which are helping you in searching, just like your JustDial.com or Sulekha.com, right? Or some classified websites. So they are all having different types of models. It could be simply banner-based payment. It could be affiliate marketing-based payment systems also, right? So the example has been given that if you are going for a digital camera purchase, so you may be going to one particular website in which you can find all the relevant information. For example, 91mobiles.com has been created for on which you can search for different types of smartphones available in the market, right? Some affiliates are having some large opt-in email list. So on that email list, they keep on sharing lots of email newsletters, including the offers from merchants. So that can be used. Okay. Affiliate marketing usually puts terms and conditions also for preventing any kind of spam emails, right? So any kind of unlawful activity or unwanted emails that can be stopped with the help of some technical options that have been given. So Snapdeal example, Snapdeal initially it was properly a deals website, but later on they actually converted themselves into e-commerce. So Snapdeal was one great example. Then there is one website called GrabOn. I hope you have seen that website and used it sometime also, because that is giving you some fantastic offers on e-commerce as well as restaurants. Right? So some companies are doing the PPC advertisement also on search engines, right? They are the digital marketing companies, but they are getting payment for all the traffic they are generating for their customers, right? So affiliates seek to find the highest earnings per click for the lowest cost per click. So that is called the search arbitrage. What they do, they are actually getting maximum number of clicks on their advertisement on search engines, because they are having more generic keywords and they are taking the customers to their own landing page. On the landing page, they are showcasing maybe 4, 5, 10 different types of advertisements, related advertisement to the customer. And from there, the customer is going to the merchant website. So these companies, these affiliates are spending money on search engine, generating the clicks taking them to their own landing page, showing the advertisement of 10 companies and taking the customer to the respective merchant website. So what is happening on search engine? Suppose they are paying 10 rupees per click, but they are getting 100 rupees per click on the landing page from the merchants who are showing the advertisement. So that is called search arbitrage. So the merchants are not directly giving their advertisement on search engine, but they are giving their advertisement to affiliate marketer. Just imagine a company like Shiksha.com, who is attracting maximum number of visitors on their own website. And on that website, the student is getting information about various courses and the colleges. And from there, the student is going to a institute's website. So what is happening? Shiksha.com paying 50 rupees for all the students who are coming to their website, and they are charging maybe 100 rupees or 500 rupees from the colleges because they are sending the students to their website for registration, right? So as an organization, we need to keep on exploring what can be different modes. If you go for Coupon Duniya, they will give you the option that you can actually add their plugin to your own browser. So what happens next time when you are going to a particular website and searching for a product? So Coupon Duniya will show you a pop-up on your browser itself. But okay, on this particular product, you can find better option on these particular websites. You are searching on Amazon, but it will show you the advertisement of Snapdeal and Flipkart also. That okay, if you go to Coupon Duniya, then there is an option for the similar product on Flipkart. If you want to click on that, you will be taken to Coupon Duniya and you can make a transaction from there. Right? So some example has been shown on the lower section of this screen. So there is one company called goodsearch.com, which is providing you charity, which is providing you highlight search terms, and they are giving you pop-up blocker.